There are multiple ways to add a clip, part of a clip, or even multiple clips to your project. Let's have a look. Starting with one of the easiest ways, you can simply tap and hold on a clip in the browser, and then drag and drop that onto the timeline. And that's all there is to it. Now, this is probably one of the most flexible ways because when you're doing this, you can choose exactly where you want the clip to go. For example, there, I've just dragged it to the end of the timeline. Or if I wanted to, I could drag a clip not only to the end of the timeline, but between two existing clips, to the beginning of the timeline, on top of the clips, or even drag and drop it on top of another clip to replace it. This gives you complete flexibility with where you want to position your clips on the timeline. But of course, at this point, what we've done is added the entire clip to the timeline. What if I only want to add a piece to it? I'll tap a clip to load it into the viewer, and then scrub my finger along the film strip to scrub through the entire clip, find a position where I want to start the clip from, and mark that as an endpoint, scrub somewhere else, and mark that as an outpoint, and then to add this to my project, I can tap and drag on the clip from the viewer itself directly onto the timeline. Or if I go back into this clip, you'll see there's a button here that I could tap on to automatically drop that onto the timeline. If I position the playhead here, and then I load another clip, and let's go ahead and mark a piece of that, and I tap on this button, it's going to insert the clip at that position, or if you're in overwrite mode, it'll overwrite whatever's on the timeline. So it's very important to know where your playhead is if you're going to use that tool. We can also add multiple clips at once to the project. Tap on the multi-selection tool, and then tap on multiple clips. You'll see they get a number, so you know exactly how many you've selected, and now you can tap and drag those down as well. In fact, you could select all the clips in an album by tapping on the Select All button. Finally, if you want to delete a clip, simply select it and tap the Delete button at the bottom of the screen. All these same techniques apply when you're adding music as well. So let's go to the music library. Select a track from my licensed music collection. Load that into the viewer, where I can once again scrub through, mark an in and an out point, and then drag and drop that onto the timeline. Those are the basic editing techniques that you have, but there are more advanced editing techniques as well, and we'll be exploring those in the Critical Editing Concepts chapter.